Sup gamers, welcome back to the channel for your daily dose of good vibes and video games. Coffee, check, orange you having a good day. I was really wanting to use that pun, if only my cup had oranges on it. Alas, they are pineapples. I'm sorry though, forgive me for that awful pun. Anyway, I still hope you're having a great day. Stupid pun or not. This game is so good. I love it. We just finished episode 1 of The Walking Dead. So this time we're going to be starting up episode 2. We have a little commune of people going on right now, but it seems like situations are going to get pretty dire in this one. We might even meet some bandits, which are going to be a separate issue apart from the zombies. Yay. With all that being said, thank you guys for clicking on the video and hanging out, and let's get back into episode 2 of The Walking Dead.
Previously on The Walking Dead.
I know who you are.
I got another good one for you.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
And you keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when he needs it.
You got it, boss.
Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
We reason with him.
With the bloody end of an axe handle, maybe. Nobody threatens my boy.
Larry is kind of a jerk. Poor Doug.
Oh, my God.
And I don't give a shit about what happens to you. But if anything happens to my daughter or that little girl you've got with you, you watch your ass.
None of these choices are easy. Especially when you have to pick one person over another, and you like both of them equally. Okay, let's go. Telltale Games presents. Whack. 3 months later. So yeah, they're pretty used to this by now. Hey!
Damn it. What'd they get this time?
Looks like a rabbit.
Looks like he's new.
Well, that's another meal lost.
Aw, man.
I still can't believe we went through all that commissary food in 3 months. It seemed like so much at the time.
Maybe you shouldn't have opened the door.
Yeah, except then I'd probably be food by now. Trust me, I have no regrets.
A rabbit's hardly a meal, Mark, but I'd take it. We're all hungry.
No kidding.
Yeah, I don't remember Mark.
When I accidentally grabbed for Carly's rations the other night, I thought she was gonna take off her hand.
Shh, buddy.
We're all on edge. Just cut us some slack.
Yeah, you're right. I wish I knew for sure how much food we have left.
We'll have to ask Lily. We'll manage.
We'll manage.
Positivity!
You know, some people aren't too happy about the way Lily's handling rations.
Lily knows it's important to keep the adults fed and functioning. Sometimes that means someone's gotta miss a meal.
You think Kenny's having any more luck than we are out here?
I sure hope so.
Mm. Yeah, between the lack of food and Kenny and Lily fighting all the time, things are getting pretty tense back at the motor inn. You know, Kenny's been talking about taking off if he can get that RV running.
Kenny won't abandon us. He's got a family to look out for. He won't abandon.
Kenny won't abandon us. He's a good man.
Yeah, I guess we'll see. Can't blame him, though. Did you hear Larry going off on him last night?
Larry!
You guys deal,
is Larry.
Seems like he's got a problem with you in particular.
I don't know why. I think he thinks I'm dangerous.
He thinks I'm a danger to the group and Clementine.
I think he's the one putting us in danger. The way Lily worries about his health, I wouldn't be surprised if she's been skimming rations for him. And I know Lily thinks he's getting weaker, but the guy's all muscle. He's a walking pile driver. I know I wouldn't want to be stuck in a room with him. And didn't he punch you in the face one
yes.
time?
Yes.
Knock me flat.
Left him for dead. Don't risk the noise. Can you make that shot?
It's a long shot. I'd hate to waste the bullets.
Trust me. If I don't think I can hit it, I won't shoot.
Ooh, I like him. It's food. Oh, mother...
Shit! Was that Kenny?
I don't know. Come on!
I like Kenny.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, shit. No, no. Please don't kill us. We just want to help our teacher. We'll leave, I swear.
Lee, you guys okay?
Get it off. Get it off. God damn it. Get it off me.
Travis, maybe they can help.
These might be the same guys that raided our camp, and
no.
We barely got away from that.
What guys? Why the fuck is there a bear trap out here?
It's okay. We're not gonna hurt you.
Don't listen to them, Ben.
Oh,
please,
come on,
just let us go. We're not a threat to you.
Kid, chill out. We'll try to help you, but you gotta shut the fuck up.
Lee, this is fucked up. We've gotta help you.
Please.
Ben, shut up. My dad was special forces. I know what I'm doing.
Just see if you can get him out. After that, you can leave us or whatever. I don't care. Please.
We gotta get him out of there.
Oh, God, thank you.
Fine, but you gotta hurry.
Stop hurry. Screaming, though.
Hurry.
Shit.
Lee, this trap's been altered. There's no release latch.
Oh, no.
Shit. Walkers. It's now or never, Lee.
Please. Get me out of this.
Mark, get the boys back.
Oh, keep
Kenny,
them off.
Keep those walkers off of me.
Oh, God. Please don't tell me we're going to chop off
Lee. Save him. Please.
Do something.
Get me out of this.
He's lost so much blood already! Please, hurry up!
Dude.
Is he gonna make it? At the Air Force base to lift ordnance. You're not cutting through that.
This is bad.
Oh,
this is
so man, bad. Dude, that sucks.
Try something.
That rock.
Why is this happening
maybe
to
you
us?
Can smash.
Last resort.
Let's go, let's go!
Please, there's you can't just leave him like this.
Really bad.
He's losing blood, too.
Blood
we gotta do something we can do.
I don't want to chop his leg off, but I think we're gonna have to. Oh god. Oh god.
Oh god.
Oh no,
damn
man.
It,
just
cut off.
No, no, no.
Leg.
Try the
we don't have time for that.
Anything.
I'm sorry, but we have to go now.
Mother.
Please, can't keep him back forever.
Fuck,
I'm just wasting it now. We gotta go.
Oh, there's go. There's a warning going up on this video. At least he fainted.
Is he?
He passed out.
Holy, you might want to put a tourniquet on that, dude.
If he's alive, grab him and let's go.
That's... Oh, they did. Okay, good. They thought ahead. So they probably knew this
behind
was going to happen.
Behind you!
Travis!
Come on, come on. We gotta move!
Run! Are you kidding me?
No!
This game leaves no room for imagination. It's just like boo 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 boo. Like first 5 seconds of each episode so far has just been like crazy. It's not a Walking Dead anything until somebody loses a limb. Episode 2, Starve for Help. At least he's helping out, you know? Clementine. Clementine.
Get the gates open! We've got wounded!
Shit! What the hell are they doing?
Come on, come
on!
Oh
my god! What happened?
What the hell?
What's going on?
I don't have time to explain.
Lee, are you okay?
Get him into the truck. I'll see what I can do.
Cat,
okay?
Can you fix him?
Jesus, Ken.
Lee!
I don't know.
Lee! What the hell? You can't just be bringing new people here. What are you thinking?
Hey, you want to calm down for a fucking minute?
Hey, no, I don't. I want to know why you thought bringing more mouths to feed was a good idea.
I thought we could save his life. I'm the one that took his leg. That makes me responsible.
Well, that was a stupid thing to do.
We are not responsible for every struggling survivor we come across. We have to focus on our group, right here, right now.
Well, hang on. We haven't even talked to these people yet. Maybe they can be helpful.
Come on, Lily. These are people. People trying to survive just like us. We've got to stick together to survive.
The only reason you're here is because you had food. Enough for all of us. But that food is almost gone. We've got maybe a week's worth left. And I don't suppose you guys are carrying any groceries, are you?
No.
Fine, you guys fight it out then. Welcome to the family, kid.
Jeez.
Come over here and see what I drew.
What? No, I...
Just come on, okay?
You know, you like to think you're the leader of this little group, but we can make our own goddamn decisions. This isn't your own personal dictatorship.
Oh, come on, you're being dramatic. Everything always turns into a power struggle between you two. I'm not gonna be a part of that.
Hey, I didn't ask to lead this group. Everyone was happy to have me distributing the food when there was enough to go around, but now that it's running out, suddenly I'm a goddamn Nazi.
It doesn't matter who's in charge. Those people are here now. I guess we just have to decide what happens
no,
next.
No, Lee, it does matter. One person can't be in charge of everything. You know, it might feel safe for you to sit on the fence, but sooner or later, you're gonna have to decide whose side you're on.
I don't see any of you stepping up to make the hard decisions. My girl's got more balls than all of you combined.
Dad, please. Why don't you go help Mark with the wall?
Well, I know who I wouldn't side with if Larry was involved.
You think this is easy for me? Everyone's starting to hate me because I'm the one that rations the food, but nobody else wants to. You know what? I'm not doing it tonight. You do it. There's today's food rations, but there's not enough for everyone. Good luck.
That would be tough, though. You just would look like the bad guy in, like, every situation. Oh, that really sucks. You only have 4 food items for 10 hungry people. Oh, no. That's... Oh, my God. Can't you, like, split the apple in half and, you know, split things in half?
Is he gonna be okay?
I don't know. Can you give me a hand real quick?
Sure, what do you need?
Sure, what do you need?
Just apply some pressure here while I try to close this up. You know, I thought I was starting to get used to this, sewing up people's injuries. But I mean, cuts and bruises are one thing, but Lee, this man has no leg.
I did the right thing.
It's what your husband wanted.
Figures. I love that man to death, but I swear sometimes he's dumber than a bag of hammers. Well, you've done all you can, Lee. Thanks for the help.
Oh.
Go ahead and check in on the others. I need a little space here anyway.
Alrighty. I feel like she would be good to give food to because she's kind of like the compound doctor.
Will you hold the damn board steady?
I'm trying. I didn't realize I was getting this weak already.
What do you want? A handout? Oh, I got 60 cents in my pocket, if you'll shut up and quit being such a pansy.
Larry ain't getting food.
Hey, you holding up okay, Lee? I was pretty fucked up back there. having to cut that guy's leg off.
Yeah, I just hope Katja can save him. Lily's pretty pissed at us.
Listen, I know her intentions are good, but...
But nothing! She's making the smart choice. Those parasites you guys brought back need to go.
I just don't care for his attitude. Like... Who else needs food? I don't know if I want to decide yet. I think I want to talk to everybody.
Nope.
Actually, we could use your axe. You mind if we take it?
No. Go ahead.
Yeah, give us that thing for a bit.
Oh my... Larry. Quiet, Larry. Yeah.
Here, Mark, this should help.
Thanks.
Hey, I'm the one doing all the work over here. You didn't think to give me the axe?
Come on, Larry, give it a rest. I'm sure Lee is getting pretty sick of you thinking he's a danger to the group.
Is that what you told him?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, that's right.
And what are you gonna do about it?
Look, I don't care what it is, but you two have got to start trying to get along.
The only thing I have to do is protect my daughter. And right now, that means getting this damn wall fixed. So I would appreciate it if you two would shut up and let me get back to work!
I kinda wanna come clean to the whole group about my past so that he, Larry, doesn't keep hanging it over my head. But I also kinda wanna talk to Larry. Let's see what he has to say. Lily and Kenny need to get along. Lily wants to...
You've got to talk to Lily about getting along with Kenny.
Lily can make her own friends.
It's not about making friends. We're all in this together. We gotta start acting like it.
Stuff all that.
Yep.
We'd be fine without you.
Wow.
Lily thinks we should throw these new people out.
Damn right. There's too many people hanging around here as it is.
Keep up on that fence.
Don't tell me what to do, Lee.
He's a real piece of work.
At least the kids have something to keep them occupied.
True.
How you doing, Clementine?
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Sure. When did you lose it?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise. If I find it, I'll let you know.
Thank you.
Okay, Clem. I've got to take care of some things. Why don't you go back to playing with Duck for a while?
Okay.
Aw. Let's talk to this guy.
Hey, is my friend gonna make it?
I don't know, but Kaja will do her best. I promise.
I can't believe you chopped off his leg.
There was no other way.
So who are you?
So who are you people? Our group's gonna wanna know.
I'm Ben. Ben Paul. The man you saved is Mr. Parker, the band director at my school. We all came down from Stone Mountain for the playoffs when everything happened.
How you holding up?
How you holding up, kid?
Shoot.
Well, I keep wondering if I could have done something to help, you know? Some kind of... I don't know. Something.
You did all you could. I don't know either.
I'm sure you did all you could.
Yeah, maybe.
Relax. We'll get your friend back to normal in no time.
I sure hope so.
I mean, if this happened 3 months ago, he survived for 3 months. I'm tempted to give food to Katja, Mark, keep forgetting her name. I want to call her Claire, but I know it's not Claire. Carly. I want to give it to Carly and Kenny. That's kind of what I'm going with.
Sleeping any better?
She's a good shot.
I know we should be grateful for beds, but no, I'm not.
Drugstore?
Yeah.
Aw.
Lily has me handing out the food.
Ugh, that can't be an easy job.
It's not. I won't be able to feed everyone. What should I do?
Well, if you wanted to get in good with Lily, I'd make sure Larry gets some food, even though that guy can be a real dick sometimes. On the other hand, giving that food to Kenny and his family might make him remember you, if he decides to take off in that RV one day.
What about you? You need food, too.
We all need food. I can't tell you what to do, but whatever happens, I know you'll be trying to do the right thing.
This is why I like her.
Thanks, Carly.
I think I want to give her food.
Want something to eat?
Give piece of jerky, give crackers and cheese. Let's give her half an apple.
Have an apple, Carly.
God, I used to eat an apple every morning with some granola and 6 almonds, and that wasn't enough even then. But you know what? Yes.
Word's getting out that you want to leave the motor in.
That ain't no secret, Lee. It's probably our best bet. Look, you've been good to me and my family. You saved Duck from those monsters, and you stood up to Larry at the drugstore. I won't forget that. You and Clem are welcome to come with us.
What about Carly? You should stay here.
We need you here. We have a better chance of surviving as a group.
True. Our best chance of surviving is to get away from the mainland. My mind is made up.
Oh, man, dude. Oh.
Thanks for buying me time to get that guy out of the bear trap back there.
I can't believe you cut off his leg. I don't know if I could have done it.
I didn't have a choice. It was that or the walkers.
Lily has a point about these new people being extra mouths to feed.
I know, but maybe the problem isn't that there isn't any food. There just isn't any here.
That's true.
We gotta think about moving on.
That is true. I do agree with moving on, though. I feel like Kenny's could be good without some food, though. Oh, man.
Let's hope things turn for the better. Soon.
Now there's a statement I can get behind.
Let's see who else. I do think I want to give some to Katya, though. I feel like the kids also need food. But the adults who actually, you know, hold the weapons right now might need the energy. Mark is very helpful. I'm gonna give him some food.
You ever miss the Air Force base? I mean, this wall isn't exactly military standard.
No way I'm going back there. You saw what it was like when you guys picked me up. Completely overrun.
Here, eat something.
He can get some jerky.
Thanks,
you're welcome. I do kind of also maybe possibly want to give it to her. We should think about leaving here. Let's see what
maybe
she says.
Maybe we should think about leaving the motel.
God, not you too. I know Kenny wants to leave. I think that's why he's so eager to get the RV working. But this is a good spot. We're protected. We're close to the drugstore. We have a routine now and it's working.
For now.
For now. Let's talk about you and Kenny.
We should talk about you and Kenny.
What about us?
They're arguing. It's getting pretty out of hand. You know people notice that.
Look, I'm working my ass off to make sure we have a good setup here, and Kenny just doesn't appreciate that. All we need is food.
But there is no food. You know that better than anyone.
Well, we'll just have to find some.
I think I want to give her food. I think she deserves it. She is right about having to take on the role of being the rationer. That's not an easy decision, and I feel like she deserves some for that.
Here.
I don't want anything from you.
What?
Take it anyway. You need to eat.
This doesn't change anything.
Wow, dude.
Some of these people have gone longer than me without food. They're the ones that need it.
Do you want to give some to the kids? But the adults really need it, and I feel like Katya, of all people, probably needs it. She's the freaking doctor.
Here, eat something.
Why don't you give it to Doc? I'm a little busy with your mess right now. I need space, Lee.
What the frick? He's so mean to me. I'm just trying to be nice. Don't really know that guy. Of either kids, though, of course I'd want to give it to Clementine. I'm gonna give it to Clementine.
Here, Clem. You need something to eat.
Okay. A sundae would be better next time.
I'll keep that in mind.
If you have any more food, Duck is hungry too.
Yeah, why don't we gonna get some food?
Well, choices have been made.
Not such an easy job, is it?
No. Clem's my girl, though.
I don't know how you have the strength to do this every day.
I don't have a choice.
So, me and my family don't matter to you anymore?
It's not like that.
Don't make me regret asking you to come along on the RV. You're out! What happened to my food?
You, Larry. Left.
You keep treating people like this, and your days in this group are numbered.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow.
Ken, Lee, come here, please.
He didn't make it, did he?
He lost too much blood.
God damn it. I'm getting sick of this shit.
Ken, come back. There's nothing...
Let him go, Katya.
But...
He just needs time. It's been a rough morning.
That man you brought, I tried. But he was never going to survive.
Well, at least he's not our problem anymore.
Aw.
What about the other kid?
Lily wants to... Oh, I did not see that coming. I don't know why I didn't see that coming, but I definitely didn't see that coming. What the? Put her in the face! What the?
Shoot it!
You okay?
Yeah. Thanks.
Why'd you bring him here in the first place, asshole?
Dad, calm down.
You're gonna get us all killed! Why didn't you tell us he was bitten?
What?
He was bitten, and you didn't say a goddamn word!
But he wasn't bitten, I swear!
Well, your not-bitten friend here came back to life and tried to kill my wife!
What?
Wait, you all don't know?
What the hell are you talking about?
It's not the bite that does it. You come back no matter how you die. If you don't destroy the brain, that's just what happens. It's gonna happen to all of us.
God help us.
It makes sense. In those first few days, it spread so fast.
Car accidents, suicides, everything was making more of them.
When I first saw it happen, we were all hiding out in a gym and everybody thought we were finally safe. But one of the girls, Jenny Pitcher, I think, I guess she couldn't take it. She took some pills. A lot of them.
Huh.
Someone went in the girls' room the next morning and... God.
Back off!
Whoa, lady, relax. Me and my brother, we just want to know if y'all can help us out.
I said back off!
Carly.
Don't want any trouble. Are you armed?
We don't want any trouble.
Of course, neither do we. I'm Andy St. John. This here's my brother, Dan. We're just out looking for gasoline. Looks like you folks got the motel locked down, which is fine, but if you could spare any gas, well, we'd be much obliged.
Why do you need gas?
Our place is protected by an electric fence. Generators provide the electricity.
Our generators run on gas. Look, we own a dairy farm a few miles up the road. If y'all be willing to lower your guns, we can talk about some kind of trade.
How y'all doing on food? We got plenty at the dairy.
We could always use more people.
Lee, why don't you and Mark check the place out? See if it's legit.
I'm going with you. I got your back if anything seems fishy.
Yeah!
So, what do y'all think?
Yes, you I definitely want to go check this out.
We'll bring some gas to your dairy. In exchange, you give us some food to bring back. We'll see how it goes from there.
Sounds fair. A couple gallons should power one of our generators for a while.
Couple gallons?
So, this dairy, you guys really have food?
Sure do. We lost most of the cattle, but we still have lots of milk, butter, and cheese stocked up.
And with the vegetables we grow, we got plenty of food.
They might
it's
be
nice
good
to get
people
away from
to
that
team up with
for a while. This Lily Kenny thing is starting to get ridiculous. Personally, I'd be happier if you started to take charge more.
You think they'd want me for a leader?
Sure. Everybody looks up to you.
Well, not everyone thinks I'm so trustworthy.
Because of your past. Does anyone else know?
Larry knows.
Larry knows.
Great. That can't be easy.
Yeah.
Clementine knows. She was there when we were talking in the drugstore and asked me about it. I couldn't lie to her.
What exactly did happen with the senator?
It was an accident. Now is not the time.
It was an accident. I mean, I pretty much knew about the affair. Sometimes I wonder if I should talk to the group about it.
Yes.
You don't have to. Whatever happened before things went to hell doesn't matter anymore.
Not sure everyone would see it that way.
Maybe you're right. Listen, over the years, I've reported on some pretty messed up shit. I've seen situations like yours 100 times. It doesn't have to make you a bad man.
I really appreciate that.
I mean, thank God Lee showed up when he did. Right, Lee?
Yeah, why don't you tell us a little more about yourself, Lee?
Where are you from?
Grew up in Macon?
I grew up in Macon.
Right here in the heart of Georgia. That's what I like to hear. Y'all seem pretty settled in at that motor inn. Who's running things over there?
It's a democracy.
We work as a group. All of us looking out for each other.
I hear that. There's so many dumbasses out there fighting each other these days. It's just stupid.
How many people you got over there anyway?
Not including the kids, enough to...
Nine including the kids.
You forgot Ben.
Me?
That makes it 10.
Well, we'd love to get you all out to the dairy. Like I said, we got plenty of food, and quite frankly, we could always use an extra helping hand.
Ooh. In the summers, I used to help out on a goat farm.
Yeah, that's great. Everything helps.
Mama's been running the dairy for... Well, as long as I can remember, but now it's...
You think you're going to cut me out of this?
Shit, get down.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
You and Gary are always pulling the
bandits. Who? Those look like the people who raided my camp.
Paranoia's pissing everyone.
Who are they?
Fuck you. You knew we were hungry, and you guys were keeping it all for yourselves.
Oh, no, there's
Yeah, and you know what?
More.
We ate it all. What are you going to fucking do about it?
Don't worry. Danny and I got you covered if something happens. Let's just wait this out. Don't they move on?
Fuck you!
Ooh!
Fuck you! Fuck
Idiot.
You!
Jesus.
Asshole.
Well, not good.
The world out here is going to shit. Come on, let's get to the dairy where it's safe. Here it is, St. John Family Dairy. Y'all can see how we kept this place so safe.
The fence keeps them out?
You betcha, they fry like bugs in a zapper. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
I'm going to assume that's a lot.
Ever have any accidents? This is a brilliant setup. We can't have the kids around the fence.
This is a really brilliant setup.
Suits us just fine.
This place looks untouched. You'd never know the rest of the world is in ruins.
It's worth protecting. Hence all the juice.
I thought I saw y'all with company coming down the drive.
Guys, this is our mama.
I'm Brenda St. John, and welcome to the St. John Dairy.
This here's Lee. He's from Macon.
A couple of our old farmhands were from Macon. They grow them good there.
They got a few more friends staying at the old motel.
Oh my goodness, that place is pretty vulnerable. Have you got someone with survival experience to lead your group?
I've got things under control. Kenny's working with us. Lily, we work together.
We all work together. Plus, we've got plenty of people with military experience.
Well, that's good to hear. That motel ain't the safest place. Now that y'all are here, we'll make sure you're safe and comfortable.
Ooh, we brought some gasoline.
Does that offer apply to the rest of us?
We're all incredibly hungry.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Amazing.
Can't get stuff like that anymore. Not without a cow for milk.
I love her.
That's for sure.
That's right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
Your cow is sick? What's she?
We have a vet. We could bring her here. We can help you folks out.
A vet?
Dude.
Oh my.
Wow.
Our prayers have been answered.
Maybe our whole group could come for the day.
Well, how about this? Y'all go get your veterinary friend and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls. It'll be nice to have some folks to help out around here again. Danny, why don't you come help me out in the kitchen?
Why don't I head back with the food and round up everyone for the trip over here?
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be dangerous.
I can handle myself.
Yes, you take can.
Why don't you go ahead and take Ben along anyway?
Take care of yourself, Lee. See you in a while.
Ooh.
Mark, Lee, why don't you take a look around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post. It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter. You can learn a little something about our fence. I'm gonna go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible. It's got food. And that fence? Oh man, that fence. If we play our cards right, this might turn out to be a place we can stay. So how do you want to play this?
Well, that'd be sweet. Let's make sure the place is safe. We should do whatever we can to help out. Let's make sure this place is
Before
safe.
Before we can think about bringing our whole group here to stay, we need to figure out if this place is as safe as they're telling us.
Right. Obviously, they think it's safe. But is it safe enough for the kids? I noticed a broken swing over there. Not a big deal, but maybe there's other things not working that we just can't see yet.
And checking the fence perimeter sounds like a decent way to get a good look at their defenses.
Yep.
All right. I'll keep my eyes open, and you find out what you can from Andy.
This would be an awesome place to stay, though.
So what have you found out? Is this looking like a good place to stay?
I'll keep looking around.
All right, keep me posted.
Okay. All right, let's chat. Wait.
Hey, what are you fixing to do around the barn?
Just trying to help out. I'm curious about your barn.
Just trying to find more ways to help out.
Well, I appreciate that. Tell you what, we'll find you something to do over there after we get back from securing the perimeter.
Sounds good. Pointy.
Pointy. Stabby.
I'll bet they go through a lot of wood keeping those fences repaired.
Yeah.
If a couple of tools out in the open is as unsafe as it gets, we'll be fine here. Would have been nice to have one of these back at the motor inn. Looks like the fence runs around the entire property, not just the house.
That's nice.
Yep. Can't take any chances when it comes to safety.
True that. I like that answer. All right, let's chat with him.
Hi.
Hi.
Well, I'm glad you guys decided to help us out. I noticed back at the motel that you folks are pretty well armed. You've been stockpiling, huh?
We can help protect the dairy.
Yeah, if you need some extra people to protect the dairy, you can count on us.
Well, hopefully it'll never come to that, but thanks.
Fence to stop the walkers? Are we your first guests?
An electric fence is enough to keep out walkers?
Walkers? Is that what you call them? That's good. The old one wouldn't have, but Mac, he was our foreman, he figured out how to amp it up with the generators. We used to sit out here some nights and watch the sons of bitches sizzling pop when they got too close. Closest thing to entertainment these days, I guess.
These generators are enough to power the whole dairy?
We got lots, and we gotta keep trading for fuel as much as we can, but they all work together to do the trick. Like us.
Are we your first guests?
We can't be the first people you've invited up to the dairy.
Well, no, we've made similar deals with other folks, trading for gas and food, but ultimately they moved on, looking for the people they lost contact with.
We're not done
yet.
I'm
gonna get to know the place for a minute.
Okay, well, we gotta secure the perimeter, so don't take too long.
Okay. I'm just gonna go check over here. What is that? Look at the swing. Oh, looks like there's some other stuff over here. This would be perfect for Clem.
Too bad it's broken. I'll bet Clementine and Duck would have loved something like this to play on.
Kids used to like that old swing even more than the tour sometimes.
I'll bet.
Mind if I try to fix it? How long has it been used?
Mind if I fix it?
Sure, that'd be great. Mama sure does appreciate y'all helping out.
Looks like it just needs a new board for the seat and some rope.
Yeah.
Make it safe for Clem and Duck. And let the St. John's know we can pull our weight around here.
Wonder if we can go steal that other plank that was over by, Oh, cool, we can walk faster. Can we go in the house? Oh, okay. Look at awards.
This dairy won a lot of ribbons in its day, huh?
This place was my daddy's life. Meant everything to him. You know, when he first bought this place, it was a single-story house.
Is that right?
After us kids was born, he insisted on adding a second floor. Said they had to have room for as many babies as they could have. Mama, she was done after Dan.
My folks stopped after two as well.
Then one day, the world changed. Now this place is all we have left of Daddy. That's why we take such good care of it, and why we want to share it with good folks like yourselves.
Aw. These people seem really great. I'm glad we found them. Alright. Shoe bucket.
This rope is perfect for the
Ooh,
swing.
Ooh, perfect. Snap, and then I know where to get the plank. We'll be all good. Where we go? Okay, so I just wanted to check and see if there's anything like that. Going inside?
Well, hi there, Lee. What can I do for you, sweetie?
Can I help you with anything around the house?
I think with Danny's help, I've got things pretty well squared away in the kitchen. But feel free to check with Andy. He's got a lot of weight on his shoulders these days, so I'm sure he'd love any help he can get.
Place looks amazing. How many rooms in this house? Minimal two.
Your family's done an amazing job of keeping this place up.
Well, now aren't you sweet? Thank you, Lee. The boys and I have tried to adapt as best we can, but we still keep some of our old routines to help remind us of better times.
What happened to your staff?
What happened to the rest of your staff?
Oh, we've had our share of tragedy here, just like everyone else, I'm sure. Some of our staff took off to find their family as soon as they heard the news. The few that stuck around, well, we lost most of them the first night those things showed up here. It was a tough night.
Ooh.
How many rooms does this house have?
Rooms? Why do you ask?
Just curious. Sorry, that was rude.
I'm sorry, that was rude of me.
Well, Don't you worry about it, Lee. We've got a great big dining room that will fit your whole group.
This just seems like a weird question.
Well, if anything comes up that I can help with, feel free to let me know.
Well, Lee, I sure appreciate it.
No problem.
No, I don't feel comfortable asking that question. We're fortunate enough to be in this current situation. Alright, let's get this board.
Mind if I use one of these boards?
Already making some repairs, huh? I like a guy who takes some initiative. Yeah, go right ahead.
Ooh, very good. Got a new swing. Let's go fix the swing.
All right. This shouldn't be too tough.
Well, I'll be damned. Mama's gonna be thrilled to see that old swing all fixed up.
Hopefully our kids will like it too.
Did you say something, darling? Oh, my goodness. Did you do that?
Just trying to help out a bit around here.
You know, I used to push Andy and his brother out here on that swing every night when they were kids. Seems like such a long time ago now.
Yeah, it does. All fixed. That should make everyone happy.
Leaves the bomb.com. Alright, let's go fix up the perimeter now. Hope nothing bad happens.
What's that?
Generator. You guys come along with gas just in time. Hey, don't mess with that, okay? The thing's a little tricky, and I don't want to spend half a day trying to fix it again.
Alright.
Hi.
Hi. Alright, let's go fix the perimeter.
Mark and I can help you with that perimeter now.
Oh, good. The fence will stop a walker in about 3 or 4 seconds, but gets overloaded if we leave the husks out there.
You know, Mark and I can clear the fence ourselves if you want to stay here and finish up with the generators.
Well, that'd be great. I'll turn off the northwest section, and if you guys could strip them off and look for any weak points, well, that'd be a big help.
Sounds easy enough.
Stay attentive. You never know.
That's a huge perimeter.
So how's the place looking? Is it safe enough for us to stay? If we can?
It's pretty amazing what they've done with this dairy, but let's see what it takes to secure this fence before drawing any conclusions.
I can't wait until everyone's out here. Everyone besides Larry.
What's up with you telling him what I said about him thinking I'm dangerous?
Look, you said it. You even admitted it right to him.
He's a piece of... work it out somehow. I try to be civil, at least.
I try to be civil, at least.
He's too busy being cranky to notice. There's one.
Oh, nasty. Well, what the hell is with the...
Ugh.
Arrow, though?
Lee, it's dead.
Come on, let's push it off. Maybe the St. John boys are using this guy for target practice?
Poor guy.
I don't think so.
Know who got him first, the arrow or the fence. Either way, hope he was already dead.
The bandit was using a crossbow, though. Maybe we can use it.
Disgusting.
Who do you think he was?
Maybe a farmhand? At least it's not one of us.
At least it's not one of us. Come on. I'm sure there's still a few more.
Once this fence is patched up, this place will be a fortress. God, can you imagine not having to worry about the walkers anymore?
It's useless without gas. Fortress needs people to defend it.
The fortress needs people to defend it.
True. We've got enough people. So what's your take on the brothers? They seem to have this place tied down pretty well.
What do you mean? They're delaying the inevitable? We can take this... Yeah.
What do you mean by that?
I don't know. They seem decent enough.
I just want you to know that I've got your back if anything goes down.
Thanks, Mark.
Thanks. There's another one.
I see it.
This one's kind of weak, too. This post does not look like it's doing too well.
Man, the fence burned right into its hands. I think they fused together.
Oh, nasty.
You never get used to the smell, do you?
Nope.
Christ. I can't stop thinking about dinner. Thanks for the rations earlier. It's not easy eating in front of the kids, but it's all that's keeping me on my feet right now.
We'll go ask for more to eat after. I'm hungry too.
I'm hungry too, Mark.
Do you think they're gonna be good for it? Dinner for a whole group of people?
If they've got as much food as they say, I think so.
Well, that's not good.
Come on. I think I see where they're getting in. This one must have knocked it over trying to get through. He's tangled up in there pretty good. Come on, help me get this thing back in place so we can get Mr. Crispy off of here.
I think we'd get better leverage from the other side.
Good idea.
Okay. I would not want to get shocked by that thing.
Little help here, Lee?
Holy fuck! What just happened?
The fences are on!
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here.
Oh!
I told you what would happen!
What the? Get to the gate!
No!
Get down!
You asshole! Jesus! We had an agreement! Now you're fucked!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea!
Now what?
With a fence on, that gate is our only way out!
Where's our food, you asshole? Over there! We got lucky that time!
The blades are stuck
you
in the
asshole.
Dirt!
You asshole! Now there you are! Give us the food!
Oh, God.
Get closer!
Oh, gosh. Alright, we got it.
We can reach the gate. We can get through this fence and back to the house.
Ah! Shit, that hurts.
Not great timing here.
What about our arrangements?
Oh, no.
What happened?
Shit. It's one of the dead we pushed down earlier. Gonna have to move it.
Give us the food! You fucked with us! Now we'll take what we want!
What the heck are they talking about?
Where do you think you're going? Ah, fuck you!
No, not another one! No!
I already got one of you!
Another one? How many of those things did we push down?
Apparently a lot.
On the track, we had an agreement! Now you're fucked! You asshole!
Oh, shit.
I can do this now.
Oh, no. Oh, that's nasty.
You okay?
Yeah.
Bam.
Come on. The gate's right there.
I love how this thing's like still chasing me. Oh my gosh. Oh no. Oh. Oh no.
Give us the
food. Oh.
Another one? How many of those things did we push down?
Behind the track. I already got one of you. I can do this all day.
It's a fast crawler. Can I not get away from it fast enough? Like, what? Go.
You okay?
Yeah. Barely.
Come on.
gate's right there!
Come on out! Did you really think you'd fuck with us?
Oh, thank God. I thought I was screwed again.
Let's get out of here.
You lucky sons of bitches! Go ahead and run! We ain't going nowhere!
Whoops!
Lee, what's wrong?
The electric fence came on.
The electric fence came on. Some people started attacking from the woods, and we got trapped between them and the fence.
Holy shit! Are you okay?
I heard Mark yelling. I thought y'all were giving me the all clear. Man, I am real sorry.
Oh, my Lord! What happened to you, sweetheart?
It was those bastards in the woods, Mama.
Yeah, I'll be all right once it's out.
God yeah, we need to, like, hurts. Do something?
Hey, y'all.
Mark! Oh my God, what happened?
He got shot with an arrow.
Christ, are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I should just...
He does not look fine.
Oh no, honey, come on. Brenda's got you. Come on inside now. We'll have you all sorted out. Well, you must be the veterinarian.
What kind of shit is this?
We ran into some people on the way up here. Bandits,
Larry, cut the crap.
I think it was them that attacked us.
They gave us a lot of problems in the beginning. Killed a bunch of our farmhands. We were able to get them to stop by making a deal.
What you do about these people?
Food for protection. Not like we had much of a choice, but they did stop hassling us.
God damn
Until
it.
Until now.
Carly said this place was locked down tight.
Safer here,
Maybe it isn't as safe here as we thought.
Look, we're sorry. We never had them screw with us like this. Not since we started giving them food. Listen, we may have had an agreement with those people, but we will not stand for this shit.
Ain't no way we're gonna let those sons of bitches get away with this.
You know where these assholes are?
They're hard to pin down, but I think I know where at least one of their camps are. When you're ready to go scope out that bandit camp, come find us.
Ooh. Bandits? Are you serious? This place isn't safe. We can't stay here.
Not safe? This place is a hell of a lot safer than that motor inn. I think all of us and our guns can handle a couple of punks with bows and arrows.
Agreed.
What we need to do is find a way to get our whole group out here to stay. Take this place over if we have to.
Whoa, cool your jets there, Rambo.
Okay.
These are nice people. Let's not do anything to get us thrown out before we...
For once, I agree with Larry.
I'm gonna head out and help Dan deal with these bandits. You guys should try to make friends with Andy and Brenda while I'm gone.
Well, that's easy. I got charm coming out of my ass.
Yeah, that's real charming, Dad.
Where's Ben and Carly?
Since Carly and Ben ate some of the food on the way to get us, she volunteered to stay behind and watch the motor inn until we get back.
Hey, kids, look what Lee got working for you.
A swing. I love swings, just like at my treehouse. Come on, Doc. Thanks, Lee. You're the best.
Yeah. All right. Look at gas cans.
They're storing gasoline all over the property. You can definitely tell they built this thing themselves.
What's around here? Nothing this way. Let's look at this.
Lots of hay. Enough of these might work as adequate cover from arrows, if that becomes a problem.
Hey! Alright. Use barn doors. Is there anything in there? Can we even get in there?
If there's not enough room in the house for all of us, I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts. Looks like a feeding station for the cow. Having a crop like that on hand must be great. We're gonna need to learn how to maintain it if we end up staying here.
Good corn to eat. Oh, Larry.
Wow. Can't talk to Larry.
Lee, oh my god, I'm so glad you two didn't get killed out there. Do you think Mark will be okay?
Wish I knew, but I think he's in good hands now.
Yeah? It's not too bad?
He'll be fine. I've seen guys go through worse.
How could you all bring us to this place?
Take it you and Kenny haven't made up. How do you feel about leaving the motor in?
How do you feel about leaving the motor in?
It's a welcome change of scenery.
Your dad's on board.
I don't know. If we'd just stayed where we were, then Mark wouldn't have ended up with an arrow in his shoulder.
I take it you and Kenny didn't exactly make up on the way here.
I tried seeing things from his point of view, having a wife and kid and everything, but gambling with your family's life is pretty stupid if you ask me. Hey, thanks for backing me up this morning at the motel. I know I came down on you guys pretty hard, but you do agree with the way I'm running things, right?
You're a good leader.
You're a good leader, though. Huff. Kenny's too emotional, but his intentions are in the right place. Still, it'd be best for all of us if you two could try to work together once in a while.
True, true. Okay, let's get out of here. Back to the gate.
That thing keeps a fence electrified.
Yes, it does. Okay, that's good. We already checked that. Wonder if we gotta go back up to the house then. Gotta go out and kill those bandits.
Fellas?
How you feeling, Lee? Look, I'm really sorry you almost got killed out there. We should have told you how dangerous it was.
No shit.
You saw what they did to your buddy. Nobody's safe here until we start to fight back.
True.
But how?
The two of us should go out and do some recon. Then we'll all mount up for some revenge.
Hell yeah.
Who the fuck are these people in the woods?
We don't know. I think some of them used to work at the big box up the way.
Save lots.
Yeah. Anyway, they're nutty as all hell and get mad when they're hungry.
So are you ready to head out there and find their camp?
Sounds like me. Yeah, let's go.
Yeah. It'll be a good opportunity to find out a bit more.
They're
about
nutty
and
get angry when they're Let's hungry. Hey, quit talking about me like that.
Remember, we're just doing reconnaissance for now. No use getting ourselves killed.
Clementine. Sweet, sweet Clementine.
See anything?
Not yet.
Toby! Toby!
I know it's around here. It's gotta be close.
What's a surprise?
Here.
Oh shit, you found it?
I don't know if this is a good idea. How many of them there are?
You see anybody?
Can't tell. Stay on your guard.
Stay on your guard.
Watch my back, Lee. I'm gonna check out the tent.
I do not have a good feeling about this. They are not well protected, though.
Clear. This camp's too small. It can't be their main base.
That's what I was thinking.
Take a look around anyway. There's probably some shit around here they stole from us.
Food.
Hmm. Nothing but fumes. Shit.
Well, that stinks. Oh, what if they had, like,
what's in the boxes?
Jackpot?
They're all from save lots.
The first few days, they told folks to gather to the save lots by the interstate. Anything worth taking?
Not unless you need empty cans, it's too much for one person.
Not unless you need a bunch of empty cans.
I'll pass.
Ooh, what's that?
Boxes from the dairy here.
Probably the food we've been giving them. Fuckers cross the line.
We could use that, though.
Looks like they were moving a lot of stuff. Tent looks pretty new. Anybody inside?
Two sleeping bags. One of them's kid-sized.
I was afraid of that.
Looks like they expected to be here a while. Empty.
Walkie-talkie? Camera?
What'd you find?
A video camera.
Let me see that.
Battery's dead, though.
Oh, good. What else they got over here? Let's see if we can find anything useful and then get a move on. I see you handled that gun I lent you pretty well. You a hunter?
No, but Lily keeps us all on a regular training schedule.
Lily, huh? Sounds like she's running this democracy of yours.
Yeah. Didn't check this one, though. Search crate.
Nothing.
Ooh. Looks like it was just recently used. Maybe there's something else in there.
Just water.
Ooh.
Yuck. I don't need that.
Alright, is there anything else? Check the tent. Checked that. What else? Oh.
Empty. But it looks like someone's been eating out of these. Recently.
Maybe we got a chat with somebody? Bag. What?
Don't fucking move.
Shit!
Put your guns down.
I ain't going back.
Clementine's
you
hat?
Jolene ain't going back.
Hey, we had a deal. No shooting as long as we gave you food. What the fuck happened?
You had a deal with them. I ain't them. Oh, I know you. I know what you are. And I know what you do.
You don't know me.
Steal my shit. Steal everything from me.
We had a deal. You people broke it first.
Why are you alone up here? What happened to you?
Well, that's a hell of a question, mister. They told me I'd be safe with them. Men who lived here. But it weren't safe. Not for me. Not for my girl. They didn't treat her nice. Not at all. They took her away into the woods. Wouldn't tell me where. And I begged them every way I could think. They just laughed. So I killed them. And I'm staying here till she comes back to me. One way or another. She'll come back. Now maybe you didn't hear me last time. When I asked you, sweet, put your damn guns down! You think I won't kill you? I'm gonna take this here crossbow and put a nice soft arrow right through your eyeball. And into your goddamn brain. You're not men. You're monsters. All men are monsters. Take what they want and then destroy it all. Take a can of beans. Take a little girl. It's all the fucking same to you.
Where did you get this hat?
The little girl.
You stole it from her.
So what if I did? You stole her from me.
Wait, what?
What the hell are you talking about?
You know what? I changed my mind. I'm putting this arrow right through your balls. Yeah, right through. String them up on that tree. Then I'm gonna head down to that farm and shoot every goddamn person I see.
Put down the crossbow.
No, sir, I need it. I need it to kill you fuckers. Go on, tell him, boy. Tell him what you got in mind for- Ugh!
Wow. God damn it! Wow. What?
You straight up murdered that woman!
Hardly. She had a crossbow pointed at my forehead.
I didn't see that going down
it's
any other way,
though. Shot, though. Right through the forehead. That's good shooting right there. Still, what a waste.
So, that's it. We going back?
If they ain't here, I don't know where they are. And it ain't a good idea to go tromping through the woods looking for them. So yeah, we head back. Once they see this, they'll get the message.
Poor Jolene. Got a new crossbow, though.
Come on.
Woo! Did not see that coming.
That was a hell of a ride, huh?
Jesus, Danny.
What? You ain't getting soft on them, are you? Not after what they did to your friend.
Surprised
you're back. What happened?
Handled it, Mama.
We're not done, though. Not with them.
This isn't what Terry would have wanted.
Terry?
My husband. Miss him every day.
Aww. Then screw it up for everybody, then. Why don't you?
Oh, calm down, Princess. I'll do it myself.
What's going on with them?
Dunno. Squabbling, looks like. A lot of tension with y'all, huh?
Yeah, you could say that. Don't mind them. It's how they are. They just can't agree on how to run things.
They have different ideas about how we should run our group. If they don't find any common ground, this whole thing's gonna fall apart.
No, it's just tough times. Everyone's hungry, and people get a little stir-crazy when their tummy's empty. And Lee, don't worry your head about them bandits. I'm sorry you've seen more violence than I'd have thought in your short time, but you all are safe here. Don't worry.
I think I'll go have a look around.
I love Brenda.
Don't wander too far. Dinner'll be ready before you know it. And thank your friend Koch again for me. She and the kids are in the barn with the cow. That woman is a lifesaver.
Oh, Katya is the best. Brenda is so, like, soothing. I feel like she's good to have around. Aww. Go give her the hat, yeah. Go give her the hat. I don't know. I still don't understand why Jolene had it. That doesn't make any sense. We have never seen that woman before. Oh, I thought he was gonna see something.
It's okay, Clementine. You can pet her.
It's okay. Go ahead.
Whoa. Katja says Mabel could have her baby tonight.
We'll see, Clementine.
What's this thing?
Daddy said it's called a salt lick.
Yeah, but don't lick it. It's gross.
Okay.
Did you lick it?
Yeah. No. No. Give her the hat back.
Here, Clementine.
My hat! You found it! I knew you'd find it. You said you would.
Listen, did you give your hat to anyone?
No.
Did you see any strangers around the motor inn who might have taken it?
No. Why?
It's probably nothing. Just let me know if you ever see anything like that.
Okay, I will. Hey, Lee, do you think you'll ever have kids?
I'd like to someday.
I'd like to someday. Maybe a little girl like you.
That's nice. You'd be a good daddy.
Aww.
Well, thanks for finding my hat.
You're welcome, Clem.
Do you want to pet the cow with me?
Nah, but you go on ahead.
Aw, I do.
She looks skinny.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
How's the cow?
How's the cow?
Well, better now we got Doc on the case.
When do you think we might eat?
When do you think, we might eat?
Hungry, huh? Don't worry. Mama's cooking up some good grub.
Danny and I met a woman in the woods.
We met this woman up in the woods. She seemed to know your brother.
Yeah, he probably talks a little more than he oughta.
Thanks.
Yep.
Why do I feel like something fishy's going on?
Have I missed anything?
No, not really.
I have a weird feeling.
It smells funny in here.
It's called manure.
Like manure.
What's manure?
Duty.
Kids?
She said duty. Alrighty, let's go check this out. Only one, well, soon to be two cows. Nothing to really look at in here.
Just stay close to your mom for now.
Okay.
Okay. Party pooper. Anything good in here?
Empty.
Why do I feel like we are not getting the whole truth here? Are the dairy boxes being empty, like, significant? Ooh, what's this?
Looks like a bunch of old dirty clothes. Ooh, smells pretty foul.
Nasty. Let's check this one.
It's a feeding trough.
Yes. Okay. There's one more to check.
Just some fence posts.
All right. I think that's it for the dolls. Go check this door. Is that thunder in the game? Yes.
You found it too, huh? Lee, they're hiding something behind this door.
I feel it.
Look.
I feel it.
They got boxes of stuff. Something metal and sharp.
Don't get paranoid.
It's my job to be paranoid, Lee. I got my whole family on this farm right now. How about you? What about Clem?
I'll protect her no matter what.
I'll protect her no matter what.
I know you will. Look, that guy with Katya, what's his name? He locked it up real tight the second we came in. I definitely heard a noise back there, Lee.
What?
My point is, we gotta know for sure. So go find a hammer or something, and I'll have this thing off in a second. You back me up in case them farmers come running.
Hang on, man. Think this through. You smash the lock. Then what if it turns out you're wrong? You just fucked your chance to get a good meal in those kids you're trying to protect. Use your head, Kenny.
All right, Professor. What'd you have in mind?
Let me have a look at what we're dealing with first.
Hey, Lee. You know how to pick a lock, right?
No. Why would you say that?
Well, you're, you know, urban.
Oh, you are not saying what I think you're saying.
Jesus, man, I'm from Florida. Crazy shit just comes out of my mouth sometimes. Sorry.
What?
What?
See those screws? Instead of breaking the padlock, we can just take off the assembly, have a peek inside, and then replace it all again like nothing ever happened.
All right. Sounds like you got a plan. I'll hang around and keep an eye on that guy with the cow.
Andy.
Shit, I thought that was Danny. Whatever.
Can I help you boys find something?
Kenny heard a noise. Just checking out the barn.
Just checking out the barn here. Never been to a dairy farm before.
Just don't roam around without me or Danny. The farm can be a dangerous place. You know, the bandits and all. Sorry about your friend. Hey, do me a favor. Don't fuck around with this door, okay? Just, you know, Mama gets nervous.
Andrew, I need your help again.
No problem. Right away, Doc.
I feel like they're hiding like a zombie back there. Maybe it's one of their zombie loved ones, and they still feel like there's a chance. Distract Andy to get him out of the barn. Okay.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
Got a screwdriver? Why do you lock that door? We're just gonna ask it.
Why do you lock that door?
Because we can't afford to lose our shit to the people in the woods. They come down here every once in a while and raid our stuff, even with the fence.
You got a screwdriver?
For what?
Never mind.
Danny mentioned he needed something.
Did he say what?
Shit, I can't remember now. Sorry.
All right. Be right back, Doc.
Should we have been honest with him? But they haven't been completely honest with us, and they just won't be forthcoming about what's behind the door. Okay, is Kenny gonna have to help me?
I still can't get that lock off the door.
You probably just need a screwdriver or something.
Yeah, but where is there one?
Okay, let's do this.
False alarm. I'm back.
Ah, shoot. Where is there a screwdriver?
So, how does a woman like yourself run this whole place?
Oh, I managed just fine. Plus, I had my boys to help out. I couldn't do it without them.
Larry's getting his game on! Okay, so we need to find... Where would one be hiding? I feel like there would be one... Probably by these tools, but let's go check. Maybe she's seen one? Who knows? You never know.
What's going on, Lee? Did something happen?
Something odd with the barn.
There may be something going on with that barn.
I'm telling you, Lee. The longer we stay here, the more trouble we're getting ourselves into.
Maybe Lee's
right. What exactly do you think I'm supposed to do about it?
If you want to go in there and start rooting through other people's shit, then get to it. But if it's up to me, we should just take our food and go.
What were you and Kenny arguing about when I came back from the camp?
He's losing it, Lee. He comes over and starts talking about searching the barn and that these people are hiding something. The way I see it, we just need to skip the dinner and get our food to go. But I'm starting to think your friend over there has another agenda.
About your dad.
It's been 3 months. Your dad still treats me like I'm some kind of asshole.
Yeah, well, don't expect that to change. That's just how he is.
So he's the asshole. Does he treat you like that too?
Does he treat you like that too?
Look, my dad can be an ass sometimes, I know that. But he's not a bad guy. He's got a lot of pain. He's been through so much, and lost pretty much everything. And it's hardened him, you know? Yeah, he's bitter and hateful, but that's all just to protect himself. And me. All he's got left in the world is me. And that goes both ways.
Aww.
So yeah, he's probably gonna keep treating you like crap, but that's just because he still has one thing left to care about. So don't judge him. And don't judge me for sticking by him. He's my dad. And I love him.
Well, that changes everything. I'm starting to think they may be hiding
after
something.
After what Kenny told me, I'm starting to think they may be trying to hide something.
You two are just asking for trouble. But if you insist on wandering around, I'd be careful, Lee.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Watch yourself, Lee.
Thanks. I do want to know what's behind that door, though, just out of curiosity. But we do need to find a screwdriver, though. Use the gate. If I was a screwdriver, I'd probably be hanging out in this toolbox.
It's a small toolbox. It's
probably got a small screwdriver. Oh, come on. Multi-tool?
Multi-tool. That should be handy.
Oh, I thought it was just like one of those pliers. Can we grab it?
You're just gonna borrow this for a second.
Alright. We gotta go distract him again. Hey, every single time he stands up straight like that, I always think he's seeing something that makes me jump. Okay.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
Danny needs something again.
All right.
Be right back, Doc.
Okay, this time, like, close the door, buy yourself a little bit more time.
Go.
Okay, let's do this.
False alarm. I'm back.
Found a multi-tool.
I picked up something I think could help with the lock.
All right, good to hear.
I tried distracting Andy, but he keeps coming back.
There's got to be something out there you can mess with to keep him busy for a while. What about those generators?
Ooh, good idea, Kenny. Good idea. Right, let's go mess with this generator. That's why it wouldn't do anything. Okay. Just turn it off? Or should we look at the panel? I feel like if we want to keep him out there longer, we probably got to do something with the panel. Open panel.
Guess I'm going to need a screwdriver for this.
Oh, I thought I had the multi-tool selected. Whoops.
There.
Alrighty. Use belt.
Ow! Damn it! Thing is moving fast.
Oh, let's turn it off.
There. That should do it.
Oh, God.
thing through a belt. Damn it. Oh, son of a fuck. Oh, this take forever.
Go. What are you doing? Okay, good. Nothing to see here. I'm just gonna go mosey on back in the barn here. We got this. Here we go. Moment of truth. Come on. I hope this is it. Third time's a charm. Alright. Let's go break in. Does that mean food?
Mom! Dad! Dinner time! It's dinner time!
Okay, honey. Let's get that.
Dad! Dad! Come on! Let's eat!
Kenny, come along, honey. Kenny, come on. Don't make the children wait.
I'll make an excuse for you. Get that thing off.
Go. I'm impatient. All right.
Screws holding it to the door.
Yep.
If I can remove them, I don't even need to deal with the lock.
Exactly. All right. Come on. Hopefully we only need to do 4 of them.
What the hell you got in that back room?
Look, we have food here, but Danny and I still gotta do a lot of hunting to keep everyone fed. When we catch something in the woods, we skin it and dress it back there. Mama doesn't like us to make a mess in the house. So you see, nothing to worry about.
What kind of food are they skinning back there, though?
Oh, Brenda,
biscuits?
You
wow.
are an angel.
Oh,
excuse
boy.
Us, we had to block the back door after
that was uber creepy.
Upstairs. Don't worry, that was a while ago, and I ain't been back inside since.
Everybody sit down, I'll go get the meal. Oh, this is a delight.
I could eat a horse.
Where's Mark?
Now, don't you worry about him. I've already brought some food up. You just let him rest.
Mind if I wash my hands first?
Bathroom's right outside in the hall. And be sure to get under your nails. You've been mucking around in the dirt all day.
I don't like this. I feel like we should go check on Mark.
Danny's baseball trophy. Seems like it's been years since kids were playing sports for fun. Andy's college degree. These boys aren't stupid. High school diploma. This dairy must have meant a lot to them before the walkers destroyed everything.
What's this?
Walkers aren't getting through that thing.
Nice bathroom.
I could use a shave.
I kind of want to go check on Mark, make sure he's okay. Something's wrong.
Farm books, cookbooks, nothing out of the ordinary here.
I have an idea. I hope I'm wrong.
Where the hell is Mark? I thought Brenda said he was up here resting.
I hope to God that I am wrong.
What do they need so much morphine for? Candles. Smart.
Musty as hell.
I guess someone needed some first aid recently. Ugh, what is this stuff?
There's something behind
the
bookshelf.
Looks like a bunch of medical waste in here. IV tubes, saline. What would dairy farmers need with this kind of stuff?
I know what they're doing.
Huh, yep. Where's that cord going?
Yep, let's plug it back in. Probably activates that bookcase, right? Oh yeah, oh no.
What the hell?
What the f- Okay, we can't go through that door. Go, 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 go. No. Nope.
Phone books,
I know.
Cookbooks. Nothing out of the ordinary here.
What? No. I know. Oh, somebody flipping heard that. Don't even tell me. I f***ing knew it.
Mark, what the hell happened?
Brothers.
What the hell happened to your legs, man?
Don't eat dinner.
Oh my God.
Clementine.
What the f- Oh my God. Oh my. Oh no. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it.
Don't eat that!
Huh? Lee, Jesus, man. Did you find something?
Yes.
Oh, sit your ass down, Lee. This lady has made you a meal.
You have?
Yeah, Lee. What's gotten into you?
He just had a start.
He could use some goddamn manners.
You're eating human meat.
That's crazy.
What the
That's
hell?
Ridiculous.
You're scaring the kids, Lee.
Lee, what the hell is wrong with you?
Don't indulge him, Lily. There's always something with this guy.
Mom, I was eating that.
What is going on?
We need to get the kids and everyone out of here. We need to go now.
Everything could have turned out okay for you folks.
He would have died anyway. We gotta think about living.
Settle down, honey. Growing up in rural Georgia, you're taught not to waste. It's how I was raised and how I raised my boys. Now, you got monsters roaming around that do nothing but eat people. And for what? To continue to rot till they eat some more. We think we can put that meat to better use.
Oh, I'm gonna puke.
You're all sick. Sick in the head.
Lee, that's not a very nice thing to imply.
Oh,
Andy is right.
God.
We go after folks who were gonna die anyways, one way or another.
He wasn't gonna die. I got shot in the arm.
Like y'all.
Clementine, run!
Nobody's going anywhere.
Oh, jeez.
We got lots of use for y'all right here.
What the fuck? The fucking what?
Put your guns down! We're walking out of here!
Don't go near my fucking family!
I don't want to die. Mommy, what did I eat?
Everyone, everything will be okay!
Lee? Lee?
Let go of her, you son of a bitch!
Told you.
Come on!
this game?
Keep us in here.
What the fuck is this game, dude? I can't even. I had a feeling though. The second we found the closet with all the medical crap in there, and the mom was acting weird, I was like, there is something wrong. And I had a feeling, and I hoped I was wrong, but I was in fact not wrong. This was absolutely crazy. Woo! I think I'm gonna end it here for now, though. What a cliffhanger. You're gonna have to wait until next episode to figure out what happens. As am I, and I'm pretty bummed about it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that crazy episode. Super creepy. Clearly, we can't just trust anybody, but it'd be kind of cool if we could take over the family now. We can, like, just take over their entire farm, and then we don't have to worry about them anymore. Kind of what I'm hoping happens, but we're gonna have to find out next time. Thank you guys again for subscribing. Thank you for liking the videos. Appreciate the support. Have a great rest of your day, and I will see you guys in the next episode of The Walking Dead. Bye!